It's finally here! The movie that everyone has anticipated about the franchise no one knew about 3 years ago. It's Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2. Back with the music, a talking raccoon, a tiny tree, and some guy named Chris Pratt. Film Cocktail has designed a special drink just for one of their characters. We call it a Yondu. So now let's get mixing and see what the boys think of this new film. Feels good on the melon. So, we watched Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2.
I'm a-holes.
So what did you think of it? First impressions. What was your first impression of this?
That was a great movie. I laughed more than this movie. I haven't laughed in any Marvel movie before.
Yeah, a lot of humor. They really punched up the humor in it, which was good. I mean, Guardians of the Galaxy 1 kind of came out of nowhere. They're like E-list characters. They're not even like D-list. They're, you know.
Yeah, it's just you've never heard any of these people.
Right. I read a little bit of the comics before the first one came out, but I had no idea who really any of them were. And this one, the second one, I think you would agree that it was better than the first.
It was mucho better.
Yeah.
It was amazing. You didn't need the development as much as in the first one. We already know the characters. Came in. Starts off with a bang. Very beginning, they're trying to protect these batteries on the Sovereign's world. And this giant monster comes, and you have this really cool scene with Baby Groot.
Yeah.
Who's freaking just so cute and so hilarious throughout the entire movie. He's just dancing, and in the background there's just massive battle going on between the rest of the Guardians and the monster.
Yeah, that first scene really sets the tone. Like, it puts in the music, it's got the humor, it's kind of setting up where the characters are now, and it's a great way to segue into the movie.
The characters were amazing.
Yeah.
You had the main five, Drax, Gamora, Groot,
Quill, Rocket.
Then you had Yondu back, and you had Nebula back, and there was some good dynamics between Nebula and Gamora.
Mm-hmm.
Like, they're sisters, and they're trying to, like, they're at odds throughout the movie. And
which wasn't played up a whole lot in the first one, and then they kind of, it's a little more in the forefront in this, which was interesting. It added a new layer to their relationship in both characters. There's that great scene where Gamora has just had a fight with Quill, and she goes off and is just, like, sitting in a field, and you got those two little plants rubbing together. And it's just quiet, it's just a nice open shot, and then here comes Nebula to kill her, and there's like a nice little action sequence that kind of takes on the form of their sibling relationship, and that was really good. You got Ego, he's a new character played by Kurt Russell, who is Peter Quill's dad. He was pretty good, I liked him a lot.
He was cool. We can't really tell you too much about it, because spoilers and stuff, but
yeah,
He's a good part of the movie. He really brings something new to the Marvel Universe.
It was interesting that they actually put Ego in this, because in the comic books he's just a giant planet with a face.
Yeah.
Like, and just kind of floating around in space and running into people, so it was nice to see something weird like that. And it fits in a Guardians movie. As far as the main five, like, everyone was strong. Like, Chris Pratt was really good.
Everyone was strong. Everybody had their part in the movie.
Yeah. Dave Bautista as Drax. He was like born to play that role.
It was hilarious.
Yeah.
Just his laugh every time somebody tells a joke or he's just awkward. It's just funny.
And he's a little deeper in this. Like there's that part where him and Mantis, which is a new character, they kind of have like this friendship that kind of buds out through it. Mantis is almost like Drax if someone else wrote the part, I would say. Like they're both socially awkward and don't understand.
Don't understand sarcasm.
Yeah, which is really fun. Baby Groot. It's a different look for Groot. Now he's like a little kid.
He's weaker and he's getting picked on.
But he's still just as good. I like Groot in this.
He's good.
There's that scene where he's trying to get the stuff for Yondu and Rocket on the Ravager ship, and they keep telling him, and he just keeps bringing in weirder stuff.
Bringing the wrong stuff.
Yeah, he brings in that toe at one point, which is a funny part. I think my least favorite of all is probably Rocket, but they actually made you care about him.
Rocket's an asshole.
Yeah, and he kind of comes to terms with that. I would say my favorite character would have to be Mantis. Like I liked her. She was a good like, not foil, but like opposite for Drax to play off of, and they had really good bits in there that I liked a lot. So the plot. Not a lot of plot to this movie. There's a little bit there to kind of move along.
It's more of a character-driven movie than a plot-driven movie.
Right.
Which is okay when you have a big cast of characters who are all fun and interesting.
Right.
You can really play off each one and have little side stories throughout the movie.
Yeah, it's kind of there, and you just get to hang out with these people, essentially, for the duration of the movie. A lot of good action sequences in this, though.
Yeah.
Like, well,
there's some space battles.
Mm-hmm.
There's the cool scene between Gamora and whatever fucking
Nebula. like the opening where they're fighting that squid monster was good.
Yeah,
like we talked about that. That sets the tone, and then they go right into like a space battle after that. Whenever the Sovereign are chasing after them, which established this rivalry between Rocket and Quill, and that sort of moves the plot along. And then they crash on a planet. And I really like the scene where the Ravagers are coming after him, and it's just Rocket. It reminded me of like Home Alone, except like
he's
in space.
He's setting up traps in this forest. And
yeah,
taking them all on single-handedly. That's pretty sweet.
Technical aspects, like we saw this in IMAX 3D, and it was great.
Definitely go see it in IMAX. It's a movie designed for IMAX. If you don't watch it in IMAX format, you're gonna get some of the screen cut off, so you won't see the whole image.
And like the 3D looked really good. Like,
3D was good. Great. You actually noticed it. You actually saw moments of that actually kind of blew you away. Like, oh, it's coming for me. I actually grab it.
Yeah.
A lot of times the 3D just kind of...
So, like, I like the world building that they did. The
aliens all look nice.
Yeah, the aliens all look nice. They look better than they did in the first one, which they probably had more money in this one. Like, I like that early on, that planet that the Ravagers are on with like the sex slave robots.
Yeah,
that was...
The guy that's like all ice.
Yeah, he looked cool too. Yeah. And the Sovereign, which are like people that are pretty much painted gold, like hair, eyes.
Cool.
Yeah, they look really neat. And like Ego's planet had a good look to it. Everything, like, and I mean the first one did too, but this one just really like took it forward.
Fleshed it out.
And some good camera work. Like I like whenever they're like Rocket and Yondu are like doing all those jumps to get to Ego's planet, and like their faces are getting distorted. That was a great funny bit.
It was pretty. Gory too. Like at one point, Yondu just kill hundreds of guys.
Yeah,
with his little whistle arrow.
A lot of death in this movie.
Yeah,
but
it was humorous. It wasn't like they were just killing them out of this.
And it's like done stylistically, but at the same time, like it fit in the movie. It wasn't like gratuitous and unnecessary. But yeah, there was a lot of death that happens in it.
And once again, during like the first one, the music's really good.
Oh yeah.
Music really stands out in this. You got the 80s and 70s pop and rock, the volume 2 of the greatest hits.
Really. Yeah. And they blend the music in well. Like it's kind of like it's got a story connection, I guess is what
you're
trying to say.
Even at one point Kurt Russell and Peter are talking about the song. He's talking about the lyrics and going back and forth and relating the lyrics with their relationship.
Yeah.
It was cool.
I like hearing this stuff because it's music I grew up listening to, and it's good to see it in like the sci-fi setting, and some of it's set to like these crazy looking planets is really neat and kind of reminds you of like album artwork from like old Led Zeppelin or Pink Floyd albums. It's really cool. So yeah, the music was really well done. Positive and negative, what would you say? What did you like a lot about it and what did you not like about it?
I like the writing. Like, the plot was really well paced and each character had their own moment to shine. And
yeah,
you didn't dislike any of the side stories. They were all interesting. They all ended up meeting together and having this big battle at the end.
And it intertwines really well.
I didn't like Sylvester Stallone. He was in this movie for a little bit. He just... All I could think was Expendables. I was waiting for Jason Statham to pop out. And he just took me away from the movie for the 5 or so minutes he was in it.
It is a little distracting that first time you see him.
And you can't understand anything he's saying.
Yeah.
Yo, Yondu, you my... Like, get out of here, Stallone. We don't need you.
My positive, I liked the cinematography and the world building that they did in it. And yeah, the characters. Like, I just really liked this movie a lot. My one negative would be, like, there's a lot of villains. It starts off with this one, like, it starts off with the Sovereign, and then, like, Taserface kind of comes in, and then it moves on to, like, another person. We won't get into that, because that's spoiler territory. But, you know, maybe you could cut one of them out. Like, maybe you didn't need Taserface, but at the same time, it's more of a nitpick than anything. So.
It's hard to find negatives.
It is. It was really good. Yeah. And yeah, I hate to put a negative out there, but if I had to say one, that would be it. Yeah. So the drink we made for this, we made our own drink, actually. We call it a Yondu. It's blue, like his skin color. Oh my god. And we made a little orange boat fin, you know, because
he has a fin in the movie.
Yeah. So I hope you guys like the drink. We do. It's tasty.
It's pretty tasty. It's like you really got to get that orange smell.
You have to have the orange boat because you get the aroma as you're drinking it.
It adds a little class to it. Mm. Just a little bit.
So what's your final thoughts on the movie?
Final thoughts. Go see Guardians of the Galaxy. Go see it.
Go see it. In IMAX 3D.
Yes. See it in IMAX 3D. I don't like 3D a lot, and I think you said the same thing. But this one is definitely worth seeing in IMAX 3D. I'm probably gonna see it again. As far as a rating, I'd give it a 9.5. Like, I liked it a lot. It's probably one of my favorite movies of the year so far. So yeah, definitely check it out. What about you? Final thoughts?
Definitely go see it. Buy it. We're gonna go watch it again. It's that good. Guardians of the Galaxy, it's hilarious. Stands alone in the Marvel Universe. You don't have to watch all the Iron Mans and all the Hulks and all the Thors and what's going on. You can just go and watch it and have a good time. I'm going to give it a 10. 10 out of 10.
10 out of 10.
Nice. Best movie I've seen in a long time. I'm not going to give a 10 to very many movies, but I thought about it. It's great. Go watch it. Tell your friends about it. Guardians of the Galaxy 2. So drink up.
And enjoy the show!
A little fin in my mouth.
This really helps with my concussion.
Oh, I thought the arrow was in here.